Welcome to the Bag Hag Digest. Hello, beautiful bag lovers. It's Trina, and welcome back to my channel. Today I have a couple of reveals for you. They are very vintage in nature, so let's take a look. Number one is this Bvlgari wallet. I procured this from a friend at work, and I don't use wallets, but I wanted to share it with you because Bvlgari is a beautiful brand, and I think I'm gonna pass this on to the thrift store where someone else who uses wallets can make good use of it. But it is old, it's very vintage, it's in worn condition, so I'm not expecting to fetch a penny for it or anything, but do wanna pass it on to someone who will appreciate it more than me. But it is very lovely. It comes with your basic compartments and multiple sleeves and a zippered compartment. You know, standard wallet. I love the orange contrast inside. Yeah, lovely wallet for someone who uses a wallet. Second and more important item on this list is a number from Gucci. Ta-jang. This, I don't know the name of this item, it's definitely what in Japan people refer to as old Gucci, meaning pre-Alexandro days, I guess, or Alexander, the creative director that's made Gucci va-va-voom these days. Gucci is one of those brands now where I absolutely adore the bags, but in reality I don't think I'd wear any of them because my style is just a little bit more minimalist and simple, so their designs, as you might know, are over the top. But this one is very simple. It's just a suede leather pouch with a nice chain detail, and you hang it on your arm and it fits me nicely. And oh, it's my camera's not adjustable for this, but it's cute. And it's very much like the Fendi baguette in size, I think. It's a good size comparison. But it's interesting because I don't like the Fendi baguette, and I really like this one. I don't know if it's just so understated. Suede, I'm not particularly a fan of. I do like the chain, but the chain can slip off more easily. I think it's because maybe the chain is longer and also it hangs nicely in the front or on the side, so you could hold it as a clutch, whereas the Fendi baguette is not really good for clutching, I think. So this item came with your regular cards and certifications. This one here was written by a Gucci representative. It says that the person bought the item in 2000, so to me that's not that old, but I guess if I think about it, wow, that's almost 20 years ago. I don't know, to me, old is in the 80s. Oh God, I'm showing my age, aren't I? Oh. Anyway, this item is, I'll put the numbers on the bottom here in case anybody wants to look it up. I've used these serial numbers to search Google and have found plenty. Most of the items I've found online have been not so much in the suede model, although I did find this exact same one on a Singapore carousel site, or like a resale site, but based in Singapore. But the other ones I found online were made of black leather. I think eBay has a few in stock. And they resell for between $100 and $300, at least the ones I've seen. So they're not cheap. However, this one, I can brag. I love bragging about my cheap prices. This one I got for the equivalent of basically 3 Starbucks coffees. Yep. So I got it knowing that it's going to be a project bag because look on the back, my friends, it's really damaged. The person had some stains and just scrubbed in there with something they shouldn't have. It's really rough to the touch here. So I think I would like to keep this color, but black is what I have available, so and it will cover up the stains better. I might decide to keep the inside as is because it really is in good condition. The suede quality is really nice. The inside of the bag is just one lined with Gucci nylon material pocket and a long zippered section here and the serial number underneath and the Gucci tag with a little Gucci insignia'd pull tab here too. And the chain is lovely. I've actually gone ahead and polished up the chain with some Brasso. You can see a close up here perhaps. It's got the old Gucci sign here. I've polished this up too. And there are some marks here, but these are watermarks basically that I put on the bag when I was cleaning it because it did have a musty smell when it came. And I thought the best way to deal with that would be to take out the inner compartment and just soap and water it. And I did, and the must is still faintly there, but not as bad as it was. This is a common problem in Japan. When people store their items, they just get moldy and musty. It's the nature of the environment here. It gets very humid and dank in the summertime, so people do have storage issues. And that makes for a good resale market if you're able to get rid of all the mustiness in these items. And I will be able to, because I know from experience I've done it before. But I'm going to have to get some new cleaner for this item, but dye, because suede requires a different type of dyeing process. And I'm also worried when I dye it, regardless of the color, that it's going to bleed. I've had that experience with dye with suede before from my Proenza Schooler bag that wasn't dyed afterwards, but the dye did come off on my clothes, so I think it's a given with suede. However, you can buy protector, and you're supposed to, I didn't know this, but at least once a year, spray your suede goods with protector. That will keep it from bleeding and also prevent it from staining and getting warm by the rain, because rain happens. Anyway, I just wanted to share that with you guys. These are my two newest old acquisitions, you could say. I'm very excited to see how this turns out when I fix it up. Stay tuned, I'll probably put that on camera. Okay, Bag Hag signing out. Mwah!